Carl, thanks for joining us.
Good to be with you.
After a budgetary impasse last year, Congress was able to reach an accord this year. Can you explain what that was and why they were able to make some progress?
For the first time since 2008, we have a full spending budget for the federal government, and in fact, it extends for two full fiscal years. In addition, the debt ceiling, which had been a very big impediment in the October negotiations of last year, has been suspended through February of 2015. So after a lot of acrimony, this was all done in a very relatively peaceable way. The reason for the progress, Doug, I think, was that both sides took a tarring in the media for their obstinance last October, and both are very anxious to move on to midterm primaries and elections, which are coming up very soon.
What is this going to mean for the economy and for markets?
Two good things, I think. First, the degree of uncertainty around the American budget was a real problem for investors, certainly last October and more broadly for the last several years, and that's been taken off the table. And secondly, some of the spending discipline, which has really brought our budget down, deficit down very, very quickly, is not going to be as severe in this upcoming fiscal year, which will be good for economic growth.
So can we say that the U.S. fiscal house is in good order?
Unfortunately not. After the next 2 to 3 years where the deficit will continue to fall, it will start to rise again and significantly. In a recent report from the Congressional Budget Office, our deficit, which is currently at about 3% of our national income, will grow once again to 6 or 7% of our national income and stay there. Obviously, we cannot say that our house is in good fiscal order until we take care of some of the long-term deficit issues that stem from entitlements. And in addition, I think that the starvation of some investments in infrastructure and education are also going to be detrimental to our economic performance in the long run. We probably need to be a little less strict with some of those items.
With those entitlements, the heaviest burdens are still years away. What is the urgency?
I think steps taken now obviously will begin accruing benefits almost immediately, and they'll grow over time. In addition, we have tremendous fortune at the moment because the interest that we're paying on the national debt is at a very low rate. If we can keep control of our budget and if we can demonstrate to investors that we're serious about it, we won't have to worry about that interest cost rising to a point where it's out of control.
Well, Carl, thanks for joining us.
Good to be here.
Thank you for listening. For more insights from our economic research team, visit northerntrust.com/view.